Harper Audio presents Road Dogs by Elmore Leonard, performed by Peter Francis James. Copyright 2009 by Elmore Leonard. Production copyright 2009 by HarperCollins Publishers. They put Foley and the Cuban together in the back seat of the van and took them from the Palm Beach County Jail on Gun Club to Glades Correctional, the old red brick prison at the south end of Lake Okeechobee. Neither one said a word during the ride that took most of an hour, both of them handcuffed and shackled. They were returning Jack Foley to do his 30 years after busting out for a week. Foley's mind on a woman who made intense love to him one night in Detroit, pulled a Sig Sauer 38 the next night, shot him, and sent him back to Florida. The Cuban, a little guy about 50 with dyed hair pulled back in a ponytail, was being transferred to Glades from the state prison at Stark, 5 years down, 2.5 to go, of a second-degree murder conviction. The Cuban was thinking about a woman he believed he loved, this woman who could read minds. They were brought to the chow hall, their trays hit with macaroni and cheese and hot dogs from the steam table, 3 slices of white bread, rice pudding, and piss-poor coffee, and sat down next to each other at the same table, opposite 3 inmates who stopped eating. Foley knew them, Aryan Brotherhood, neo-Nazi skinheads, and they knew Foley, a Glades celebrity who'd rob more banks than anybody they'd ever heard of. Walk in and walk out, nothing to it, until Foley pulled a dumb stunt and got caught. He ran out of luck when he drew his honor maximum bob in criminal court, Palm Beach County. The white power convicts accepted Foley because he was as white as they were, but they never showed they were impressed by his all-time high number of banks. Foley sat down, and they started in.
Jesus, look at him eat. Jack, you come back because you missed the chow? Boy, you get any pussy out there? He didn't. What did he bust out for? I heard you took a 38 in a shank, Jack. Is that right? You let this puss shoot you? Federal U.S. fucking marshal. Shows her star and puts one in his leg.
Foley ate his macaroni and cheese, staring at the mess of it on his tray, while the skinhead hard-ons made their lazy remarks Foley would hear again and again for 30 years from the Brotherhood, from the Mexican Mafia, from Nuestra Familia, from the black guys all ganged up. 30 years in a convict population, careful not to diss anybody, but thinking he could stand up with the tray, have the tables looking at him, and backhand it across bare skulls, show 'em he was as dumb as they were, and get put in the box for 60 days. Now they were after the Cuban.
Boy, we don't allow niggers at our table.
They brought Foley into it, asking him,
how we supposed to eat, Jack, this dinge sitting here?
Right now was the moment to pick up the tray and go crazy, not saying a word but getting everybody's attention, the tables wondering, Jesus, what happened to Foley? And thought, for what? He said to the 3 white supremacy freaks with their massive tattoos, this fella's down from Stark, you understand? I'm showing him around the hotel. He wants to visit with his savior, I point him to the chapel. He wants a near-death experience hangover, I tell him to see one of you fellas for some pruno. But you got this stranger wrong. He ain't colored. He's 100% greaseball from down La Cucaracha way. Foley looking at the 3 hard-ons and saying, cha-cha-cha. Later on, when they were outside, the Cuban stopped Foley.
You call me a greaseball to my face?
This little bit of a guy acting tough. Where you been? Foley said. You get stuck with the white power ding-dongs, the best thing is to sound as dumb as they are, and they'll think you're funny. You heard them laugh, didn't you? And they don't laugh much. It's against their code of behavior. This was how Foley and Cundo hooked up at Glades. Cundo said Foley was the only white guy in the joint he could talk to. Foley, a name among all the grunge here, and knew how to jail. Stay out of other people's business. Cundo's favorite part of the day was walking the yard with Foley, a couple of road dogs in tailored prison blues, and tell stories about himself.
how he went to prison in Cuba for shooting a Russian guy, took his suitcase and sold his clothes, his shoes, all of it way too big for him, came here during the time of the boat lift from Mariel 27 years ago, man, when Fidel opened the prisons and sent all the bad dudes to La Yuma, what he called the United States, for their vacation. How he got into different hustles, didn't care for armed robbery, liked boosting cars at night off a dealer's lot. He danced go-go in gay bars as the Cat Prince, wore a leopard print jockstrap, cat whiskers painted on his face, but scored way bigger tips ladies' night at clubs, the ladies stuffing his jock with bills.
Here is this middle-aged mama with big tetas. She said to me, come to my house Saturday. My husband is all day at his golf club. She said to me, I give you 10 $100 bills and eat you alive.
Man, and how he was shot 3 times from his chest to his belly and came so close to dying he saw the dazzle of gold light you hear about when you're approaching heaven, right there. But the emergency guys see he's still breathing, blood coming out of his mouth, his heart still working, man, and they deliver him alive to Jackson Memorial, where he was in a coma 34 days, woke up, and faked it a few more days, listening to Latina voices, the nurse helpers talking about him. He learned he was missing 5 inches of his colon, but healed, sewed up, good as new. When he opened his eyes, he noticed the mozo mopping the floor wore a tattoo on his hand, an eye drawn at the base of his thumb and index finger, a kind of eye he remembered from Combinado del Este, the prison by Havana. He said to the mozo,
we both Marielitos, huh? Get me out of here, my brother, and I make you rich.
Foley said, you thought you'd be cuffed to the bed.
Maybe I was at first, I don't know. I was into some shit at the time. Didn't work out.
A cop shot you?
No, was a guy, a picture taker in South Beach, before it became the famous South Beach. Before that, he was a Secret Service guy, but quit to take pictures. One he did, a guy being thrown off I-95 from the overpass man down to the street, the guy in the air, Jola Brava, sold to a magazine and became famous.
Why'd he shoot you?
Man, I was going to shoot him. I know him, he's a good guy, but I was not going to prison for a deal this woman talked me into doing with this dumbbell hillbilly rent-a-cop. I didn't tell you about it. I pull a gun, and this guy who used to be in the Secret Service beats me to the draw, puts 3 bullets in me, right here, man, like buttons. I should be dead.
Cundo grinning now.
But here I am, huh? I'm in good shape. I weigh the same now as the day I left Cuba. Try to guess how much.
He was about 5'4", not yet 50, but close to it, his dyed hair always slicked back in a ponytail. 130, Foley said.
128. You know how I keep my weight? I don't eat that fucking macaroni and cheese they give us. I always watch what I eat. Even when I was in Hollywood, going out every night, is where I went when the mozo got me out of the hospital to L.A., man, see a friend of mine. You understand? This was the time of cocaine out there. All I had to do was hook up with a guy I know from Miami. Soon I'm taking care of cool dudes in the picture business, actors, directors. I was like them. I partied with them. I was famous out there.
Foley said, till you got busted.
There was a snitch. Always. Even in Hollywood.
One of your movie buddies.
I believe a major star, but they don't tell me who the snitch is. The magistrate set a $2 million bond, and I put up a home worth $2.5 million I bought for $600 when I was first out there. All the rooms with high ceilings. I pay 9 bills for another worth an easy $4.5 million today. Both homes on the same canal, almost across from each other.
Foley said, in Hollywood?
In Venice, California, like no place on earth, man. Full of cool people and shit.
Why do you need 2 homes?
At one time, I had 4 homes I like very much. I wait, the prices go up to the sky, and I sell 2 of them. Okay, but the West Coast feds see Florida has a detainer on me for homicide. A guy they say I did when I was in Miami Beach.
Foley said, the mozo? Cundo said,
it's funny you think of him.
Why didn't you trust him?
Why should I? I don't know him. They say one time, we out in the ocean fishing, I push him overboard.
Foley said, you shot him first? Cundo shook his head, grinning just a little. Man, you something. How you think you know things?
What I don't understand,
Cundo said, walking the yard with Foley.
I see you as a hip guy. You smart for a fucking bank robber. But two falls, man. One on top of the other. You come out, you right back in the slam. Tell me how you think about it. A smart guy like you have to look at 30 years.
Foley said, you know how a dye pack works? The teller slips you one. It looks like a pack of 20s in a bank strap. It explodes as you leave the bank. Something in the door frame sets it off. I walk out of a bank in Redondo Beach. The dye pack goes off, and I'm sprayed with red paint, people on the street looking at me. 20 years of going in banks and coming out clean, my eyes open. I catch a dye pack and spend the next 7 in federal detention, Lompoc, California. I came out, Foley said, and did a bank in Pomona the same day. You fall off a bike, you get back on. I think good, I've still got it. I made over $6,000 in Pomona. I come back to Florida. My wife Adele divorced me while I'm at Lompoc, and she's having a tough time paying her bills. She's working for a magician, Emil the Amazing, jumping out of boxes till he fired her and hired a girl Adele said had bigger tits and was younger. I do a bank in Lake Worth with the intention give Adele the proceeds to keep her going for a few months. I leave the bank in the Honda I'm using, America's most popular stolen car at the time. Now I'm waiting to make a left turn onto Dixie Highway, and I hear the car behind me going vroom, vroom, revving up. The guy can't wait. He backs up and cuts around me, his tires screaming like I'm a retiree waiting to make the turn when it's safe to pull out.
You just robbed the fucking bank, Cundo said.
And this guy's showing me what a hot dog he is.
So you go after him,
Cundo said. I tore after him, came up on the driver's side and stared at him.
Gave him the killer look, Cundo said.
That's right, and he gives me the finger. I cranked the wheel and sideswiped him, stripped his chrome, and ran him off the road.
I would have shot the fucker, Cundo said.
What happened, I tore up both tires on the side I swiped him. By the time I got the car pulled over, a deputy is coming up behind me with lights flashing.
That's called road rage, Cundo said. I'm surprised a cool guy like you losing it. How you think it happened?
I wasn't paying attention. I let myself catch a dye pack in Redondo Beach, something I swore would never happen. The next one, 7 years later, you're right, I lost it. You know why? Because a guy with a big engine wearing shades, the top down, no idea I'd just robbed a bank, made me feel like a wimp. And that, Foley said, is some serious shit to consider.
Man, you got the balls to bust out of prison? You don't have to prove nothing.
Out for a week and back inside.
What could you do? The girl shot you? The chick marshal? You don't tell me about her.
Karen Sisko. Foley kept her to himself. She gave him moments to think about and look at over and over for a time. A few months now, but there weren't enough moments to last 30 years. Foley's conviction didn't make sense to Cundo.
You get 30 years for one bank, and I'm maxing out 7.5 for killing a guy? How come you don't appeal?
Foley said he did, but the attorney appointed by the court told him he didn't have a case. If I can appeal now, Foley said, I will. If I have to wait too long one of these nights, I'll get shot off the wire, and that'll be that. Cundo said,
let me tell you how a smart chick lawyer can change your life for you. I was told by the Florida state attorney, the federal court in L.A. gave me up because I can get the death penalty here or life with no parole. But this cool chick lawyer I got, and I thank Jesus and St. Barbara I can afford to pay her. She say the reason L.A. gave me up, they have a snitch they don't want to burn.
One of the movie stars, Foley said, you turned into a drug addict?
Miss Megan say maybe because they like his TV show. Plays a prosecutor. Bust his balls to put bad guys away. You have to meet her, Miss Megan Norris, the smartest chick lawyer I ever met. She say the Florida state attorney isn't sure he can put me away on the kind of hearsay evidence he's got. She believe he's thinking of sending me back to the coast. They find me guilty out there, I do 295 months, man, federal. You know how long that is? The rest of my fucking life. But Miss Megan say they don't want me either, if they have to give up their snitch, the famous actor. So she say to the state attorney here, you don't want Mr. Ray? She say,
even if he was to plead to second degree and does a good 7 for you straight up, no credit? Man, the state attorney is tempted, but he'd like me to do 25 to life. Miss Megan tells him she can get that out on the coast, where they have new prisons, not all joints full of roaches, toilets that back up. No, she sticks to the 7 and adds, okay, 6 months. Take it or leave it. She asked me, can I do it? Look at me. I already done 5 years at Stark. It got crowded up there, the state prison, man. So they sent me to this joint, supposed to be medium security, because I don't fuck with the hacks or have snitches set on fire. Once they can prove. Can I do 3 more?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.